In this video, we're going to talk about encephalitis. Encephalitis is irritation and swelling or inflammation of the brain, most often due to an infection. What are the causes, incidents, and risk factors associated with encephalitis? Encephalitis is a rare condition. It occurs most often in the first year of life and decreases with age. The very young and the very elderly are more likely to have a severe case of encephalitis. It is most often caused by a viral infection. Many types of viruses may cause it. And exposure to viruses can occur through breathing in respiratory droplets from an infected person, from contaminated food or drinks, by mosquito, ticks, and other insect bites, by skin contact with the virus. Different viruses will occur in different locations. Many cases will tend to cluster in certain seasons of the year. Encephalitis caused by the herpes simplex virus is the leading cause of more severe cases in all ages, including newborns. A number of viruses for which there is now a vaccine may also cause encephalitis. These include measles, mumps, polio, rabies, rubella, varicella, or chickenpox. Other viruses that can cause encephalitis include adenovirus, Coxsackie virus, cytomegalovirus, Eastern equine encephalitis, echovirus, and the West Nile virus. The virus causes inflammation of the brain tissue. The brain tissue swells, cerebral edema, which may destroy the nerve cells, causing bleeding in the brain or intracranial hemorrhage, and thus brain damage. Other causes of encephalitis may include an allergic reaction to vaccinations, an autoimmune disease, bacteria such as Lyme disease, syphilis, and tuberculosis can also cause encephalitis. Parasites such as roundworm, cysticercosis, and toxoplasmosis in AIDS patients and other people who have weakened immune system can cause encephalitis. Cancer and its effects on the body can also cause encephalitis. Symptoms. Some patients may have symptoms of a cold or stomach infection before the encephalitis symptoms begin. When a case of encephalitis is not very severe, the symptoms may be similar to those of other illnesses, including fever that is not very high, mild headache, low energy, and poor appetite. Other symptoms include clumsiness, unsteady gait, confusion, disorientation, drowsiness, irritability or poor temper control, light sensitivity, which is termed photophobia, stiff neck and back, occasionally, vomiting. Symptoms in newborns and younger infants may not be as easy to recognize, but they include body stiffness, irritability, and crying more often. These symptoms may get worse when the baby is picked up. Poor feeding. The soft spot on the top of the head may bulge out more, and vomiting. What are the emergency symptoms or emergency presentation of encephalitis? Loss of consciousness, poor responsiveness, stupor, coma, muscle weakness or paralysis, seizures, severe headache, sudden change in mental functions, like a flat mood, lack of mood, or mood that is inappropriate for the situation, impaired judgment, inflexibility, extreme self-centeredness, inability to make decisions, withdrawal from social interaction, less interest in daily activities, memory loss, and impaired short and long-term memory. What are the signs and tests done for encephalitis? The examination by a physician may show abnormal reflexes, increased intracranial pressure, mental confusion, mouth ulcers, muscle weakness, neck stiffness, signs in other organs such as the liver and lungs, skin rash, and speech problems. Tests done include an MRI, or magnetic resonance imaging, a CT scan of the head, and culture of the cerebrospinal fluid, or CSF, blood, urine, and other cultures. An EEG or electroencephalogram, a lumbar puncture for the examination of the CSF fluid. Tests that detect antibodies to a virus like serology tests may also be done. And tests that detect tiny amounts of DNA by PCR for that virus are also done. What is the treatment? The goals of treatment are to provide supportive care, rest, nutrition, and fluids to help the body fight the infection to relieve the symptoms. Reorientation and emotional support for confused or delirious people may be helpful. Medications include antiviral medications such as acyclovir or Sovirax and foscarnet or foscavir to treat herpes encephalitis and other severe viral infections. However, no specific antiviral drugs are available to fight the encephalitis. Antibiotics are done if the infection is caused by certain bacteria. Anti-seizure medications such as Dilantin to prevent seizures. Steroids such as dexamethasone to reduce the brain swelling, which occurs in rare cases. Also, sedatives to treat the irritability or restlessness. Acetaminophen or Tylenol for fever and headache. If brain function is severely affected, interventions like physical therapy and speech therapy may be needed after the illness is controlled. So what are the expectations and prognosis of this disease? The outcome varies. Some cases are mild and short, and the person fully recovers. Other cases are severe, and permanent impairment or death is possible. The acute phase of disease normally lasts about 1 to 2 weeks. Fever and symptoms gradually or suddenly disappear. Some people may take several months to fully recover. What are the complications of encephalitis? Well, permanent brain damage may occur in severe cases of encephalitis. It can affect the hearing, the memory, muscle control, sensation, speech, and vision. When to call your healthcare provider? Well, if you have any of the symptoms mentioned above, you think you might have encephalitis, or a family member thinks you have encephalitis, you should be evaluated right away. You must go to the local emergency department or call 911 if you have sudden fever or other symptoms of encephalitis mentioned before, severe headache, changes in mentation, neck stiffness or soreness, etc. That's it for the discussion of encephalitis. See you soon.